Hello YouTubers, in this video I want to show you here electronic kit from IC Station I got from them, and this is a kit with an NE555 timer and a 74HC595 shift register, and this is called 16 channel water light LED module. So I want to show you how that works. I'm here on the page of IC Station, and if I scroll down, you see some information about the components. You also see here the schematics, the circuit diagram. I want to go in detail in a few minutes, and you can see here also the module. I built up the module already, so I can show you this here. It looks like this, as you can see. And how that works and how the circuit works and what is maybe special with the circuit, I want to show you now. First of all, I want to show here the functionality of this module. You see here are some LEDs going around somehow. This is nothing special at the moment. I also used here plexiglass because the LEDs are very bright. So if I remove this here, they are very bright. So I will keep this plexiglass over this module. This is nothing special at the moment, but there are two buttons on the printed circuit board. And if I press a button, you can maybe observe now there are less LEDs on. And if I press the other button, you see I can make some kind of pattern. And so it's very interesting here, only with a timer and two shift registers. So no programming is necessary in order to have here this kind of LED pattern. So now I want to go in detail to the circuit. Here you can see the circuit I have downloaded from the site of IC Station. And here on the left side you see the typical circuit for the timer 555 in A-stable operation. You see here the resistor R1 and RP. And C2 here in this case, and this construction is typical for the A-stable functionality for the timer 555. Here on this side, or here you have the DC input 5 volts, and here a bypass capacitor, a big one, 10 mu or so. And so the circuit works with 5 volt because we are having here TTL components, 74 series. And I want to show you also some things I was missing here in the circuit. The first thing is I miss here the 10 nano capacitor on pin 5 for the 555 timer. It's recommended from the data sheet. So I implement this here in my circuit here on the board here on the other side. This is a 10 nano. Another point I want to say is I'm missing really the bypass capacitor. So usually, if you have digital components, you should have at least one bypass capacitor, 100 nano or 10 nano for each IC. They are missing, so they are not here implemented between pin 16 and pin 8. What's also a little bit, not strange, but a little bit difficult to see, the naming here of the pins are not the same as in the data sheet. So I modified this here a little bit. And what else I have seen is the LEDs. There is no resistance series for the LEDs in order to reduce the current. So if there is no resistor for the LED here at this point for the or at the pin of a 595 shift register, the maximum current that can be drawn here is 6 milliamps. But I think 6 milliamps for a white LED for this kind of LEDs, 5 millimeter white LEDs, is a little bit too much. They are very bright, as you have seen. So I would use 2 milliamps maybe. But maybe this was also a reason they want to have it very bright. But okay, so there's no resistance series for the LEDs. But now I want to come to explain the circuit here a little bit. You can see here in the middle the two switches, and you also can see here R3 and R4. And the question is first, why are here two resistors in the circuit? You can see switch 2 is connected to plus 5 volt, and if you press both switches, This point here is connected to 5 volts. And without R3, this point also was good to ground. That means you have a short circuit. So R3 protects from a short circuit if you press both buttons. The question is, what about R4? R4 protects here Q7, this point, because you don't know the level at the moment, for example, if this is maybe low. And if there is no R4, you have here low level, zero. But if you press the switch 2, you also will short here the Q7. So this R4 protects Q7 from a short circuit. The interesting point is now, as you can see, with this switch, you set a logical low here to this point, to the serial input, and with this switch, a logical high. So in the meantime, where the clock signal is going through the shift register, in the meantime, you can press switch 1 or switch 2, and you will include a high or low. That means you have a LED off or on, and that is shifted through the whole line here, and this is very interesting here to see. In order to have a circle, you also have to connect the serial input to the one to the last output here. So the output of this IC3 is connected to the serial input of IC2, and the output, the Q7 here of IC2, is also connected here over this way to the serial input of the IC3. So in this way, it runs like a circle. This was a short explanation of the circuit. Let me say some words about the kit. So it's very easy to solder this, also for beginners. It's a single side layout, as you can see. Take care about the polarity here of the LEDs and the ICs and also the pole caps. And then I would say you have fun with that module. This was only a short introduction to this module here of IC Station. Thank you for watching the video and have a nice time. Goodbye. Tschüss.